the next fight is another lightweight battle, and it gets you the number three contender with Gray Maynard versus the number five contender in TJ Grant.
Right.
This is going to be interesting because Gray's been on the shelf for over a year.
Right. He has. I mean, he's been, you know, he hasn't seen any action since June, I think, of 2012. But, you know, when I look at Gray Maynard, man, he's one of these fighters that one loss and all of a sudden he falls off the radar. I mean, and you can ask people like Rashad Evans, people like Anthony Pettis, people like Phil Davis. All of a sudden they copped one loss and it was like they went from contender to all of a sudden no one talks about him. Because in that time, other people moved up the ranks. And I feel like Gray Maynard kind of got, you know, shafted in a sense. I mean, he took that loss after having that nasty trilogy with Frankie Edgar, and all of a sudden, everybody forgets him, and he's not in the running as being one of the top lightweights when he was the man in the lightweight category for some time. And then you look on opposite of him, you got TJ Grant, I think the fact that he's won, rattled off four wins in a row, that's why he's got this fight. I really do.
I think he has that, and along with, I mean, we just watched Evan Dunham put on a hell of a show this past weekend, and I mean, he got robbed. And I'm thinking if Grant can keep up with Evan Dunham, and he beat Evan Dunham by UD, I don't think he's going to have a problem beating Gray. I really don't, because in that last fight versus when Maynard lost to Frankie Edgar, he got winded. I mean, he put on that blast and almost beat Frankie, and then just after that, he didn't have anything left in the tank. So I'm thinking with a year off and not seeing any real opponents and not seeing, you know, actual ring fights as opposed to sparring with someone, I think Maynard's going to come out and look rusty and Grant's going to beat him.
See, I'm actually going the opposite. I'm going to go with Maynard. I think TJ Grant hasn't seen enough stiff competition. He hasn't gone up against the people that Gray Maynard has gone up against. And I think when you talk about Gray Maynard running out of steam, I think when you're fighting somebody like Frankie Edgar, he can make anybody run out of steam because that guy just has so much fucking go. He's got so much fucking heart and he just doesn't quit. So he wears you down, you know, when you think you've got him finished, then he has a way to pull it out like he did against Maynard. And I just think Maynard is just too good of a talent for TJ Grant. So I'm going to go actually with Maynard finishing him in the second round.
Ooh, you might want to go back and look at Maynard's track record about finishing things. He's still working on that Happy Meal.
I'm going to put it on a limb, Shorty. That shit will probably break and I'll fall and break my neck with it. But I'm saying that Gray Maynard's going to finish him in the second round.
You do understand that 12 of Maynard only has 12 wins and 10 of them are by decision. You do.
I know.
Okay. All right. Cool. I mean, as long as you know all that, because here's the thing. If I don't tell you that, someone else is going to tell you that below us. So I figured I'd just throw it out there.
I don't give a fuck what nobody says. Right. I just think that it's a lopsided. I think that it's just, I don't know. TJ Grant has not gone up against that many formidable opponents in my mind.
And TJ Grant is going to prove you wrong and win this by UD. So that's what I think.
Are we betting dinner on this shit, man?
No. Not on that fight.
Right. Okay. That's okay. Okay. I just wanted to make sure that you were that behind your man, TJ Grant.
No, but you know what? And not this next fight we're going to talk about, but the one after that, I'll go out on a limb and I'll put my money on somebody that I don't think you're going to expect me to. But
comical, brash, and sometimes politically incorrect. The Uncut Sports Show. Non-traditional sports coverage delivered the way you like it by your uncensored co-hosts, Kevin White and George Bedford.